All right, so you have three words, right? Bhava, Bhakti, and Prem, right? So everyone talks Bhakti, 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 but cannot really understand Bhakti, devotion, without understanding Bhava and Prem. So first you have Bhava, not Bhava, Bhava or Bhava. Bhava, Bhava means sentiment. Sentiment. You must have that dormant feeling, that dormant sentiment for the, I'll say it like this, the personalities of Godhead. In order to then be devoted. And this leads to devotion to the personalities of Godhead. Because anyone who looks at Radha and does not see the personality of Godhead and only sees Krishna as the person, then they're missing. Krishna doesn't like this. Okay? So enough with the sexism. Okay. So first you must have bhava, real sentiment. Then you have bhakti, devotion. And as the devotion grows, then you reach what is known as prema, prem, love of Godhead, of the personalities of Godhead. And then we have these two schools. We have what is known as the Dvaita school, the dualistic school, and we have the Advaita school, the non-dualistic school. But they are both blubbering idiots. The Advaita school, many times, they like to think in terms of the truth is impersonal. The truth is nothingness. The truth is emptiness. The truth is a void. Makes me feel like telling these people, well, why don't you just shut your nothingness trap up then? Because your emptiness dribble is driving me insane, because at least I'm not pretending not to be here. So, if everything is an illusion and it's all about nothing, then just shut up. Shut up, because nothingness should not be able to talk, right? Nothingness should not be able to reason. Okay. And then you have the Dvaita. They say, well, we are personalists. God is a person. And we must worship Him like this. And only like this. And this is the supreme form of the God. And if you do not worship the supreme form of the God, then you go to hell. And this form of the God is less than the other form of the God. Only this form of the God is the only one. You miss also. And then we have Jeho! We have Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, right? With Krishna himself. There's a deep science behind this, and there's a reason why he's called Chaitanya, which means consciousness. And then we see that he is initiated by this guru. And this guru's name is Ishwarapuri. And Ishwar means the controller, the Lord controller of all. And Puri means city. But anyway, this Ishwarapuri was not a Vaishnava, was not a member of the Dvaita personalist schools. You know, these personalist schools, they argue about who is more supreme than the next. This is nonsense. This Ishwarapuri belonged to a school of thought called the Mayavada. The Mayavada philosophy. which was established by Sripad Shankaracharya. The Mayavadis believe that the supreme truth is Brahman, or spiritual energy, intelligence, which is unlimited, without form, it says here, but I will say beyond form, beyond limited form, beyond materially diseased form, or activity. According to this philosophy, all living beings are one with Brahman. Yes, this is true. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. I am spirit soul. But these, all of us, most of us, are covered by illusion and therefore temporarily separated from Brahman. They say that when the illusion is gone, the living being becomes again one with Brahman and loses its identity. Well, what happens is they lose their false identity. Their main idea is that everything is God. Yes, everything comes from God, so therefore everything is God. You cannot separate from God. But because of God's unlimited love, it allows for this free will. So you can continue. You will continue being because you are part of the infinite being. You can call it God. But being God is not an attainment. You cannot attain God. Forget about it. But you see, people like to argue over which school is best. They're both wrong. They're both right and they're both wrong. If Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was on such a trip, right, then he would not have taken initiation from this Mayavadi, this so-called impersonalist. And the reason why there is good valid point for this Nirguna philosophy, Nirguna, beyond qualities, no qualities, what quality? Because people like Ishwara Puri did not want to fall for any just knucklehead that came along claiming, I am God, I am God. So he initiated Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, gave him the name, the monastic name Chaitanya. And so, do you think that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was looking down on him? No, he was like this to him, and sincerely. That's why it's called a science. You cannot enter into Sarguna, the eternal quality, without first being filtered through the Nirguna. No quality, no material taint. Only then can you enter into the eternal quality. Do you understand? So I'm saying, putting this video on because I want to explain also this term, Supreme Personality of Godhead. They are supreme because they are reflecting and expressing the Supreme Being. This is why they are supreme. It is not a fixed thing. It is not a fixed thing. So much more I can say. Hari Om Namah Shivaya. Hari Om Namah Shivaya. Hari Om Namah Shivaya. Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Balaram Avadhutaya.